he has a point. Do you guys agree with that?
I agree. I think that there's a two-prong couple of underlying reasons why people have seen this video and why it has gone viral. I think for the past few years, in an attempt to discredit the right, the Democratic Party has been very intentionally volatile. They have had comedians holding up a, you know, beheaded version of President Trump. We have had riots on college campuses. They have not been reflecting the openness to discourse and tolerance that these people who are leaving the movement feel that they would like to be represented by.
Well, that's another thing I had a problem with this video, is this conflation between people who vote Democrat, people on college campuses, the whole PC left with the Democratic Party. I think that there are some distinctions we need to draw there. Who were the people who defended Ann Coulter's right to speak at Berkeley last year? Bernie Sanders and Elizabeth Warren. So we should draw some distinctions there.
Yeah, I also think what we have to realize is that, yeah, he has a point, or else almost seven minutes of my life wouldn't have been taken out to watch it.
That was my doing, really.
Yeah.
So I'm the one that's really controlling.
Fair enough. No, fair enough. Devin, I blame you.
Yeah, with the 2016 election, what you saw was that a lot of young Republicans did bolt to vote for Trump, or to vote for Clinton, and that was counteracted by a lot of older Democrats switching to vote for Trump. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, there was a lot of that with the Trump election. So,
I think in terms of sticking with your party or feeling represented by your party, there is a historical precedent for people saying, I no longer feel represented. I am not seeing the results that I would like to be seeing. I don't feel like my party is fighting for me. And so they make this permanent switch. We saw it with the Reagan Democrats. We saw it in the 1930s when the African American vote stopped voting Republican because the Democrats did not take their votes for granted at that time. Mm-hmm. And so we have seen this in the past. And I think that this is just the modern day version of that. And while it is possible that there is discord in both parties, I think that the Democratic Party is the one that's experiencing the first potential break.
So if they do experience a potential break, I think we should figure out is it justified or not, because, you know, to my last point, there's this political there's this cultural left, and then there's a Democratic Party. Should those things be conflated? Is it fair to conflate those things?
No, Sam, I think you're right. I don't think it is, but I think it's been absorbed into, if you're a Democrat, you're liberal, and if mm-hmm. you're a Democrat, then you're liberal, then you're also Antifa. Mm-hmm. Just like if you're a Trump supporter, a la me, I am a racist, homophobic, Islamophobic,
right.
A-hole.
Yeah. So,
and I am not, I mean, I'm an A-hole sometimes. Look, I'm going to be real here. But I am none of the other things, okay?
So what about the idea that that Trump might turn out some new voters, like some Latino voters that didn't turn out last election because now they're terrified that they're seeing this administration?
I think there's the flip side to that. You have the alleged, and it depends on